Well, good morning, church family. It is Saturday, April the 11th. And what I've never heard this called, this Saturday called this, but last night I was watching Max Lucado and he called it Silent Saturday, the Saturday in between the crucifixion and the resurrection. And I thought, what an appropriate name, Silent Saturday. So I hope and pray that today, this day is a day of reflection for you and encouragement for you as we are in this situation. But what I want to do today is I would like to turn all of our attention to the resurrection, turn all of our attention to what Jesus did for us so many years back and what he continues to do for us today, and the love that God has for you and me for this time, and also just for because of this weekend and what it means. But before I get into that, I do want to say that tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Online, we're having our Easter at home, and if I would love for you guys to take a part in that and to join me there, and as Pastor Zach gives an amazing message of hope and encouragement and truth, and it's just going to be a great time as we come together at home, virtually come together at 10 a.m. tomorrow at fbfirst.com or at First Baptist Church Fernandina Beach on Facebook. So please be a part of that tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. Now, I do want to say that this may be my last daily devotion of the Do Not Be Afraid or Fear Not series. What an appropriate time to lead up to the resurrection. I may do some more once or twice a week type of devotions beginning next week. I'm really just seeking after God, and whatever I really truly feel like God's leading on my heart to do is what I try to do. And so I may maybe starting something like that next week, but or I may come back and start doing another devotion every day. So all depends on where God leads. So just be aware of that. So I've enjoyed my time together with you for the last week and a half, but I feel like today kind of culminates in everything of what God says, do not be afraid. Now, what I would encourage, though, is there's so many more instances in scriptures where God says, do not be afraid or fear not. What I would encourage you to do is that even if this is our last video, my last video devotion kind of on this subject, I would love for you to get in God's word. Just Google a list of do not be afraid statements in the Bible and just read them. And just read them and be encouraged, because God so many times tells us in his word, do not be afraid, fear not, because we serve an amazing almighty God. And so let's just get in the text today. It's just a couple of verses I want to read, because it's the truth, the underlying truth of what this weekend is all about, is what yesterday was about and the death and the burial of Jesus, and what tomorrow is all about and the resurrection of Jesus. And so let's just read it. First verse comes out of Isaiah chapter 12, verse 2, and it says this. It says, behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and I will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. And the next verse comes out of Psalm chapter 27, verse 1. It says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? And the truth that we're going to talk about today of who God is and what God does for us is God meets us and fulfills our greatest need as human beings. And he does it by what we celebrate this weekend. He does it by the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus. You see, God is our salvation. What we need more than anything else, more than getting past circumstances in our life, more than the needs in this daily life, what we need more than anything else is for salvation. For our soul salvation. And God provides that through his son Jesus. And so what I want to do is I want to encourage you today, Silent Saturday, I want to encourage you by just letting you know that no matter what is crumbling or going on around us, no matter what's going on, God provides the greatest need that we have, and that is salvation. And maybe with everything that has happened, maybe we've forgotten that. And so what I want to encourage you guys today is to take your eyes off of what's happening and throw your eyes back on the fact that God has given us salvation through Jesus. And all we have to do is confess with our mouth that Jesus is Lord, believe with our heart that he rose from the dead. And the Bible says in Romans chapter 10, verse 9, we will be saved. And I pray that for you today. Your greatest need, my greatest need, is to understand that God loves us so much that he gives us salvation through Jesus. And I pray that today, this Silent Saturday, the day before Resurrection Sunday, that you would have that and experience that. And if you don't know how to do that, man, I tell you, just find a church around your area, find someone that you know follows Jesus and call them up and ask them. It's so important to understand that that is our biggest need, and our God fulfills it. God Almighty fulfills it through Jesus. So today what I want to do is this, is I want to be thankful. What I want to be thankful for is Jesus. I want to be thankful for the fact that so many years ago, he stepped out of heaven, walked this earth, died, and then a few days later rose again. Why? For you and for me. I am so thankful for that. And that is where, as it says in Psalm chapter 21, the Lord is the stronghold of my life. And then in Isaiah, where he says, I will trust and not be afraid because God is my salvation. The Lord is my strength and my song. And today I pray that he is your song. So I'm thankful for God, thankful for Jesus for doing that. And who I'm praying for, I'm praying for you today. I'm praying that God would strengthen you today, and that today that we just are praising God for the salvation, that because of what's happening tomorrow, we're praising him, and that you would find joy in that, in our salvation, in your salvation, not our salvation, but in your salvation, because I'm finding joy in my salvation, and I hope you do that too today. I love you. Let's pray, and then let's pray. Father God, you're amazing God, and I love you. Thank you, God, for your son Jesus and the grace and mercy that comes through knowing him. And Lord, I just want to thank you, God, for Jesus. I found my joy in Jesus, God. Lord, let me remember that, Father. Let me sit back every day and just remember who you are, God, and what you've done. Lord, I love you. I honor you. And God, I just want to pray for everyone watching, Lord, my church family, those that maybe attend another church somewhere, maybe those that don't attend a church at all. God, I pray, Lord, that we realize that you supply our greatest need, and that greatest need is salvation. From death to life, Lord, you can bring our soul from death to life. All we have to do is confess you and believe in our heart that you rose from the dead, and then follow you every day of our life, God. Lord, surrender our lives to you, God. Lord, I pray for those online that maybe have forgotten about that. Lord, give them, Lord, allow the Holy Spirit today, right now, just to permeate their heart and just to saturate them, God, and to quicken their spirit. And God, I just pray for those that may have never done that before, that today, that you draw them to you. The day before Resurrection Sunday, I pray so much, God, that they would do that. Lord, I love you. I honor you. Thank you for your son, Jesus. In Christ's name, amen. Well, guys, I've enjoyed this little time. Remember, as always, turn down the volume of the media, turn up the truth of God's word. And in Christ Jesus, there is always hope. And I pray that you are encouraged today. And I love you. I miss you. And God bless. Have a great, great Silent Saturday, and have an amazing time tomorrow worshiping our King of Kings on Resurrection Sunday. Don't forget, 10 a.m. tomorrow morning, fbfirst.com, as we celebrate Easter at home. God bless you guys. Have a great day.